Fairytale Tales, Rapunzel. Rapunzel wants nothing more than to have the longest hair in the whole wide world. If only it would grow past her knees, all the way down to her toes. But it grows oh so very slowly. Rapunzel brushes it and brushes it morning, noon and night. But it never gets any longer. It's nearly time for bed, so she takes out her favourite hair clip.
But, oh no! It pings out of her hand and into the air.
It flies across the room and lands straight down a little mouse hole. Rapunzel reaches inside to find it. And as she does, something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger until there is just enough room for Rapunzel to crawl through to the other side. Hidden just behind the skirting board is the most beautiful forest Rapunzel has ever seen. The flowers are so pretty and they smell so sweet. Rapunzel skips through the tall, tall trees. She is too busy exploring to look where she is going. She nearly bumps into a witch.
Hello, my pretty,
says the witch. Rapunzel is a little frightened. She has never met a real witch before.
Don't be afraid, my dear,
she says.
I am a good witch. I make wishes come true.
Rapunzel is so excited. She knows just what to wish for.
I wish for the longest hair in the whole wide world, she says.
Very well, says the witch.
She casts a spell and just like magic, Rapunzel has the longest, most loveliest locks you have ever seen.
Oh, thank you, thank you, says Rapunzel. Her hair is so golden and so very, very long. She is so happy.
There's just one thing I forgot to tell you,
cackles the witch.
In return for your lovely long locks, you must live hidden away in the tall, tall tower.
She points her bony finger and casts a spell. Rapunzel disappears in a cloud of magic sparkles. At first, Rapunzel doesn't mind being locked away in the tall, tall tower. She's far too excited about her hair to worry about anything else. She sits down at the golden mirror to admire her lovely long locks. Brushing her hair with a fancy golden brush makes her feel very special indeed. The witch looks up at the little window.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your hair so I may climb up and see you, my dear.
Rapunzel doesn't like the sound of that, not one little bit.
My hair is not a ladder, she says.
Don't worry, says the witch. You have magic hair, so it won't hurt at all.
Rapunzel lets her lovely long locks tumble all the way down to the ground. The witch huffs and puffs as she slowly climbs up to the top. But it doesn't hurt. Not even one bit.
I brought you some lunch, my dear,
says the witch.
It's my favourite. Bat wings and cricket's legs.
Poor Rapunzel. Suddenly she doesn't feel very hungry.
I'll keep it for later, she says.
I'll be back with your dinner at 5 o'clock on the dot, says the witch.
She waves goodbye to Rapunzel, Then she climbs all the way down to the ground. Rapunzel is all alone, with only bat wings and cricket's legs to keep her company. All of a sudden, she feels very sad indeed. A single tear rolls down her cheek, and then another, and then another. A brave and earnest prince hears Rapunzel crying. He will find her and help her. The prince walks round and round and round the tower, but there's no door to be found. Why are you crying? He calls up to the little window. I am locked in this tall, tall tower, all on my own, says Rapunzel. Oh dear, says the prince. What can I do to help? Rapunzel has a very good idea. She lets her hair tumble all the way to the ground. Climb up, she says. We can play games all afternoon. So the prince climbs all the way up to the top of the tall, tall tower. Rapunzel is so happy she has someone to play with. They are having such fun together. But then the grandfather clock starts to strike five.
Oh no! The witch is coming, says Rapunzel. You must go.
So the prince climbs down Rapunzel's hair as quickly as he can. He promises to come back and rescue her from the evil witch. But little do they know, the witch is spying on them. And she's heard every word. She is so angry. She marches up to the little window.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your hair!
She calls. Rapunzel does as she's told. But the witch casts a spell and her long golden hair disappears.
Now you will never escape,
cackles the witch.
You certainly won't get any dinner.
Poor, poor Rapunzel. She feels just miserable.
The witch stands guard at the bottom of the tall, tall tower. She will never, ever let Rapunzel escape. But Rapunzel has a plan.
You must be very lonely down there, she says. Why don't you come up here instead?
The witch is quite lonely, so she casts a spell and Rapunzel has her long hair once more. The witch climbs all the way up to the top of the tall, tall tower. Rapunzel asked the witch very nicely if she would plait her hair.
It's too long to do it all by myself, she says.
Rapunzel pretends to help, but instead she wraps her hair round and round the witch's long, bony fingers. Now she can't cast any spells. Rapunzel shouts as loud as she can. She knows the brave prince will come to save her. The prince hurries through the forest to rescue Rapunzel. He climbs up the ladder all the way to the top of the tall, tall tower. The witch is so angry. But she can't cast a single spell. Rapunzel is so happy to see the prince.
Quickly, hand me your sword, she says.
He gives Rapunzel his sword and she chops off her long flowing locks. The witch is furious. They are getting away!
She shakes and shakes
until puff! There's nothing left but a puff of smoke. The Wicked Witch is no more. Rapunzel and the Prince are so happy. Let's play some games to celebrate, says the Prince. They have lots of fun playing together in the forest. It seems like no time at all before Rapunzel has to go home. She waves goodbye to the Prince before crawling through the little mouse hole. It is lovely to be home safe and sound. There are no witches here. And look, she's found her favourite hair clip. Even though Rapunzel loved her lovely long hair, it was very hard to keep neat and tidy. And besides, her own hair suits her just perfectly.